Today's topic is about herbs, spices, and condiments. Herbs, spices, and condiments is our topic for today. Herbs, spices, and condiments, that is our topic today. And as you can see, it is in three parts. We have herbs, we have spices, we have condiments. Those are three different things, and so they are divided into subtopics. So our first subtopic is going to be condiments. So you can have condiments as the first subtopic. And we usually say that condiments are items used to season food at the table and when cooking. So these are things that we can add to food when we are still cooking it, and we can also add to food when it is at the table. For example, something like salt. We use salt in cooking, and also we use salt at the table. Tunakuanga na salt shaker. So salt is a good example of a condiment. Another good example is something like pepper. And again, you find it at the table. Another example is vinegar. We use vinegar to marinate our uncooked meats and fish and poultry. And we also use the same vinegar at the table or even to make salads. So when we are talking of condiments, we are talking of those items that we use both in the kitchen to cook food and also at the table, and the purpose of them is to flavor or to season food, to give it a particular taste. So let's have a definition of condiments. Condiments are substances. Condiments are substances added to food. Condiments are substances added to food during cooking or at the table. Condiments are substances added to food during cooking or at the table to improve the flavor of the food. To improve the flavor of the food. So something that we use to improve how the food is tasting, that is what we call a condiment. Another statement. Examples of condiments include number one, salt. Number two, pepper. Number three, mustard. And number four, vinegar. So those are the four condiments that I'm going to talk about: salt, pepper, mustard, and vinegar. Let's begin with salt. Salt. This is essential. Salt. This is essential for stabilizing body fluids. It is essential for stabilizing body fluids and preventing masculine cramps. And preventing masculine cramps, in other words, muscles, making muscles not to have cramps. So masculine cramps, and is used in many ways in culinary, and is used in many ways in culinary. Now, culinary is cookery, so it also has many other uses in cookery. Let's have a subtopic still on salt. Uses of salt. Uses of salt. The uses we are going to be writing are uses connected to the kitchen or connected to food production. So we are going to be seeing how we use salt in the kitchen. Number one, to preserve food. Preserve food. Now, when we use salt to preserve food, we call that salting. And salting is an example of a traditional method of preserving food, mostly meat. So salting, adding salt. So that is one use of salt to preserve food. Another use, number two, it enhances the flavor of food. It enhances the flavor of food. Flavor is taste. So when you have food with salt and food without salt, you can tell the difference. So it enhances the flavor of food. It gives food some characteristic good flavor. Number three, it is used in marination. Used in marination. When we marinate meat, we are making it, we are seasoning it and making it tender. So it is used in marination, comma, during cooking, and at the table. It is used for marinating, comma, marination, comma, during cooking, and at the table. So we can use salt to marinate. Then when you are cooking, because the recipe will tell you, check the seasoning. When you find it is not enough, we'll add. And also when the service person is setting their table, they also have what they call the cruet set, and salt shaker is usually there. So you use salt before cooking, during cooking, after cooking. Let's have a statement. I'm done with the uses. Salt is obtained from A, mines. We mine salt, it's a mineral. So mines. B, underground lakes. So mines, underground lakes. Lakes and sea, from the sea. So we get salt from what? Mines, underground, from the lake, and also from the sea. So those are the places where we get salt. Write this particular question down. This is your own revision question that you are going to do. You find the answer in the handout that I already attached. List five types of salt. List five types of salt. So when you look at the handout that I sent, you are going to find the types of salt there. So make sure you look at them. Let's look at storage of salt. Storage of salt. Storage of salt. Point number one, store in a cool, dry place. Store in a cool, dry place. And why are we saying this? When you put salt in a wet place or where there is moisture, it is going to absorb that moisture. And then it will stop being powderly and it will become lumps. Itashikana ikuwe inakaa lumps. Ikae mawe mawe. And when it's like that, it cannot be used again as salt. So store in a dry, cool place. And point number two, it should be kept in tight containers. It should be kept in tight containers, and this is for the same reason. We are keeping it in tight containers so that it does not absorb moisture. That is all about our first condiment, which is salt. Let's go to condiment number two, pepper. Condiment number two is pepper. We usually have many types of peppers. We have like black pepper, we have white pepper, we have cayenne pepper, we have paprika. So all those are peppers. Now pepper ni pilipili. So pepper is also a condiment. We can use it for marination, we can use it when cooking, and we also find it at the table. So let's write this about pepper. This is mostly found in South India. It's mostly found in South India. Full stop. The fruits are known as peppercorns. The fruits are known as peppercorns. So before we grind and get pepper, because pepper is in powder form, those fruits, the two seeds, they are known as peppercorns. Peppercorns. Another statement. They are used in soup. They are used in soup, comma, sauces. So you can use them to, you can use them when you are making sauces. So soups, comma, sauces, comma, stews, etc. Another statement about pepper. White pepper is hotter in flavor than black pepper. When we say hot here, we mean mkali. So white pepper is hotter than black pepper in flavor. White pepper is hotter in flavor than black pepper. Now you might be wondering, why are we having white pepper and black pepper? I've already said that the fruit is the peppercorn. But the peppercorn is usually black. It has a black coating. So when you grind it, ikiwa hivyo full, you get black pepper. But if you remove the coating, alafu una grind, now you get white pepper. So the outer coating is the one which is black, and which makes it become black pepper when it is not removed. But once you remove the coating, and now you grind, you are now able to get white pepper. Jason, hakuna kitu. Then now we can have another subtopic, another statement about pepper also. We also have cayenne pepper, write that. We also have cayenne pepper. I'm writing it here on the chat. We also have cayenne pepper, which is red in color. So cayenne pepper is usually red. You look at it from the tin. We also have cayenne pepper, which is red in color. And it is used in savory dishes. I'm also going to type savory on the chat. It is used in savory dishes. Savory simply means salty. Salty. Things that have salt. So savory dishes. Full stop. It is obtained from, so here we want to know how we get cayenne pepper. It is obtained from grinding chilies and capsicums. Grinding chilies and capsicum. We all know chilies, pilipili, zile za green, zile zenye, they turn red, zikiwa ripe. And then you have capsicum. Capsicum ni hoho. So when you grind hoho together with the chilies, yes, you are able to get, you are able to get cayenne pepper, and it is a very hot pepper. Inakuwa ni kali sana. Another statement, because you also have another pepper. Paprika is another pepper. Paprika, it's commonly known as Spanish paprika, but just write paprika because that's the name. So paprika is another bright red pepper. Paprika is another bright red pepper, but mild in flavor. When we say mild, we mean it is not too hot. So paprika is another bright red pepper, but mild in flavor. Full stop. It is used in goulash. Goulash is a dish. You can have beef goulash, you can also have bean goulash. So in goulash recipes, you find paprika as an ingredient. So it is used in goulash, comma, decorating hors d'oeuvres. Or you can just write salads, decorating salads. Salads, the cold starters. Decorating salads and other cold items. Decorating salads and other cold items. Full stop. So when we talk about pepper, we have black pepper, white pepper, we have cayenne pepper, and we have paprika. All those are peppers. The only difference is how some of them are hotter than others. Also the composition, like if it is cayenne pepper, it's capsicum and chilies. If it is white pepper and black pepper, it is the peppercorns. For black pepper with the coating, for white pepper without the coating. So that is it. We can now have our condiment number three. So remember, our number one was salt, number two pepper, and now number three we have mustard. Mustard. I don't know how many of you know mustard, but we use it in the kitchen mostly when we are making dressings, if we are making mayonnaise, if we are making vinaigrette. And the reason of using mustard is to simply season. To season and bring some color, because it usually has some rich yellow color. Yellow is what you call mustard. So you can see the name mustard, also the color is mustard or yellow. So let's write something about mustard. This is obtained by grinding the seeds. This is obtained by grinding the seeds of white and black mustard plants. Obtained by grinding the seeds. When you say seeds, we mean the mustard seeds of white and black mustard plants. Full stop. So we have white mustard and we have black mustard. So when we combine the seeds and we grind them, we are able to get mustard. There are two types of mustard. Namely, there are two types of mustard. Namely, the English mustard, and B, French mustard. A, English mustard. B, French mustard. Let's begin with A. We want to know, why do we have English mustard and French mustard, and what is their difference? But what you need to know is they are used for the same purposes. They have some slight differences. So write this: English mustard. English mustard. This is a mixture. It is a mixture of ground black and white mustard seeds. This is a mixture of ground black and white mustard seeds colored with turmeric. Colored with turmeric. If you know turmeric, turmeric is very yellow. So a mixture of ground black and white mustard seeds colored with turmeric. Also, another statement about it. It is the hottest in taste. It is the hottest in taste. Nimesema tukisema hot inamaanisha ukali. And in this case, when I say hottest, I'm saying it is hottest, comparing it to the French mustard. I have said English mustard is a mixture of ground black and white mustard seeds colored with turmeric. That was my first statement about it. And the other statement I've said is it is the hottest in taste. And hot here means nikali. So when I compare it with the French mustard, the English mustard is hotter. Another statement about it. It is served with roast or boiled beef. It is served with roast or boiled beef, ham sandwiches, ham. It is served with roast or boiled beef, ham sandwiches, comma, grilled steaks, etc. etc. Another statement about it. It is also used to flavor sauces. It is also used to flavor sauces, e.g. mayonnaise. Used to flavor sauces, e.g. mayonnaise. So we use mustard to flavor items. We flavor soups, not soups, we flavor sauces. We serve together with beef or sandwiches or grilled meats. All that. B, French mustard. French mustard. French mustard. This is darker in color than English mustard. French mustard. This is harder, not harder, it is darker in color than English mustard. Than English mustard. So when you look at them, the English mustard is lighter compared to French mustard. Another statement, it has a sweeter, milder taste. It has a sweeter, milder taste. Sweeter, milder taste. So it is not as hot as English mustard. It has a sweeter, milder taste. Another statement about it. It is served with grilled steak. So that particular use is similar to the English mustard. It is served with grilled steak. And its last use, It is used in flavoring vinaigrette. Used in flavoring vinaigrette. I said it is served with grilled steak. Grilled steaks. Served with grilled steaks. And the last use I've said, used in flavoring vinaigrette. Vinaigrette is a salad dressing made using vinegar, French mustard, and then we put salt and some olive oil. We whisk them together. That is what we call vinaigrette. So it is used there. That is all about our number three. Condiment number four, vinegar. Condiment number four is vinegar. That is our last condiment, vinegar. Condiment number four, vinegar. It is used in the following ways. Vinegar. It is used in the following ways. So we all know vinegar, but we know there are various types of vinegar. We know we have white vinegar. We know we have apple cider vinegar. We have red wine vinegar. But when you talk of vinegar, basically, we are talking about its use in the kitchen. And majorly here, I'm talking about the white vinegar, the most common vinegar, the white vinegar. So these are the uses. Number one, making vinaigrette. Making vinaigrette. Now, I've already said what vinaigrette is. It is a salad dressing, and the basic ingredient is vinegar. That is why you see that the name is starting with vinegar, vinaigrette. So that is the first use of vinegar, making vinaigrette. Number two, used in cooking. Used in cooking to add a piquant flavor. Used in cooking to add a piquant flavor. Piquant means sour. Ukali. So piquant flavor to various sauces. Piquant flavor. Then use number three. Used in marination of red meats. Used in marination of red meats and game. When you talk of game is meat from the wild animals, like buffaloes, like antelopes. Those are the game meat. So anytime you get meat from the wild animals, we call it game meat. So vinegar is also used in the marination of meat. Then Roman 4, another use. Used for preservation of certain types of vegetables. Used for preservation of certain types of vegetables, e.g. gherkins, certain types of vegetables, e.g. gherkins and capers. I've written them on the chart. Preservation of various vegetables or certain types of vegetables, e.g. gherkins and capers. So sometimes when we buy gherkins and capers, they're usually preserved. You buy them, they are vegetables, but they are in a glass bottle, and there is a liquid in there. That liquid in there is vinegar for preservation purposes. So now this brings me to the end of condiments. Remember we said herbs, spices, and condiments? Those are three different categories of food commodities. So the condiment part is done. The things that we use to flavor food, and we use them when we are cooking, and also we can use them at the table. Now, let's go to another part. The other part is herbs. So write herbs as our subtopic now. Herbs. And when we talk of herbs, we are simply talking about plants. So it does not matter the part of the plant it is, provided it is a plant product because of the term herb. So when we talk of herbs, we are talking of things that we get from plants. It could be the root of the plant, it could be the stem, it could be the leaves, it could be the seeds, the flowers, but it is a herb because it is coming from a plant origin. Now, let's define what herbs are. Herbs are leaves. Herbs are leaves, comma stems. Herbs are leaves, stems, or flowers of plants. Leaves, stems. Jason, unafanya nini? They are leaves, stems, or flowers of plants, and are available either fresh or dried. They are available either fresh or dried. So what are we trying to say here? We get in the green grocers, kama kwa kibanda ya mboga. For example, when you go and buy dania, ile green dania. Dania, we call it coriander. That is a herb, but you can get it green. But when you go to the supermarket, bado utapata mkebe pale kwa spices, imeandikwa coriander. That one is dried. So we have fresh and dried. Same case with parsley. We have green parsley, which you get from the market, and we also have parsley in a tin, which you get at the supermarket. So that is the green and the dry. So whether green or dry, if it is a herb, it remains to be a herb. Let's have a subtopic. Uses of herbs. Uses of herbs. Number one, to garnish various types of dishes. To garnish various types of dishes. Mostly we use parsley sana sana, garnish chakula. So one major use of herbs is to garnish. Use number two, to enhance and improve the flavor and aroma of food. To enhance and improve the flavor and aroma of food. Now, for example, when you use dania, usually feel that there's another added taste. When you use something like mint is also a herb. You can find it kwa mkebe in a supermarket. You can also find it in the market. So when you use mint, again, mint is very strong. It brings in a different flavor, a different taste and aroma. aroma is the smell. So herbs bring that, improve the flavor and aroma. Use number three, to disguise the unpleasant taste of some foods. To disguise, ku disguise ni kuficha. So to disguise, the unpleasant taste. So those foods which are maybe very strong flavor, something like fish, unpleasant taste. To disguise the unpleasant taste of some foods, e.g. fish. So use the herbs to mask that strong unpleasant flavor. Then let's have in catering, that's just a statement after those three things you've written there. In catering, herbs are used in catering, herbs are used in soups, comma, salads. Use them in soups, so to garnish. We use them in salads. We use them in sauces. Also use them in fish dishes. Fish dishes, in this case, to during cooking, not only to garnish. We also use them for flavoring, so flavoring and the garnishing. So all those are all the uses of herbs in the kitchen. Right, examples of commonly used herbs. Examples of commonly used herbs. So there are those herbs which are very common. When you start doing practicals in the kitchen, there are those herbs that we see nearly every day. They are every day they are in the kitchen because they are commonly used. And one is bay leaf. Bay leaf, ama bay leaves. So bay leaf. Another one is celery. You literally see celery in the kitchen every day because you use it to make stock. We have garlic. We have mint. We have rosemary. Rosemary is mostly used with chicken dishes. So rosemary. We have oregano. We have sage. Those are just examples. We have sage. We have thyme. We have parsley. Parsley looks like dania. So parsley. We also have coriander. Now coriander is dania. So parsley, coriander. Basil, people have not mentioned it. Basil, we also have dill, D-I-L-L, dill. We have chives, etc. We have got very many examples of herbs. So garlic. No, cardamom ziko kwa herb. Cardamom ziko kwa spices. Cardamom ziko kwa spices. We are going to see what the difference is. Spices are the ones which are very aromatic. Ziko na harufu, ziko juu. Hizo ni aromatic ziko in the spices. But then herbs, they are not that very aromatic, but they bring in the flavor. Yes, chia seeds ni herbs, sio spices. So chia seeds ni herbs. So we have very many examples. We cannot exhaust all of them. Now, the last subtopic about herbs, ndio twende kwa spices. Storage of herbs. So now, storage of herbs. One, when fresh, they should be kept in a cold room. When fresh, they should be stored in a cold room. To prevent wilting. Wilt is to wither. So to prevent wilting, so because you do not want them to wither, you do not want them to start turning color, you put them in a cold room. Or rather, if you don't have a cold room, in a fridge or in a freezer to make sure they remain fresh. So these are easily green, the fresh ones. Number two, when dry, they should be kept in tight-fitting bottles or containers. When dry, they should be kept in tight-fitting should be kept in tight-fitting bottles or containers to prevent them from absorbing moisture. Full stop. NB. So there is something to note when you are storing herbs. Never store in paper bags. As paper will absorb. Never store in paper bags, as paper will absorb aromatic oils. And do not store in plastic bags. As they make it sweat. Full stop. So what are we saying in this particular point? We've talked 2 points on storage. When they are fresh, store them in the cold room. When they are dry, store them in tight-fitting containers with tight-fitting lids. And now here we have something to note on the kind of place where you're supposed to keep them. We've already said in a container. So do not put them in a plastic, in a paper bag, because the paper bag will absorb the oils from the herb. When it absorbs the oil, it means even the flavor or the taste of that herb is also absorbed. It will be flat. Again, if you put them in plastic bags, the plastic bag will make it do what? Sweat. Now, if you sweat, there will be moisture in there. And we've already said that they should not absorb moisture. That is all about herbs. So what you should note is you should be able to differentiate now between a herb and a spice, because they are all plant products. But you will know the difference. Let's have spices as our subtopic. Yes, question. Ask question, Lorato.
My question is, now, like, when you wash them, like, ukitaka kuzinunua and you wash them, How do you store them? Ama, you don't wash, you just store. Then you wash when you're using.
No, you wash them. You pat them dry, and then now you are
Yes.
able to store them. So you either store, we've said, either in the cold room or in the fridge. If you are storing in the fridge, or yes, in the fridge, you can fold them, or rather cover them with a clean kitchen cloth or a container, or you can also cover them with aluminium foil and then put them in your fridge. They will stay fresh when they have already been cleaned. Yes. Now let's talk about spices. So spices is our last part of the topic. Remember what our topic is: herbs, spices, condiments. So we've dealt with condiments, things that we use to season food during cooking and at the table. We've come to herbs, parts of plants. And you see, they can either be fresh or dry. And we mostly use them to garnish, to cook, to disguise flavors of unpleasant foods, to improve the flavor, all those. Now, let's look at spices. We want to know also what they are. Now, if you remember what I've said, when somebody has given me cardamom, and I've said it is a spice, the reason why we have things classified as spices. The major characteristic of a spice is the aroma. Aroma ni harufu. Like the way you feel when somebody is cooking pilau. You know they have pilau masala, they have many spices. You can feel the aroma from afar. So that aroma is the major characteristic of a spice. So for us to classify something as a spice, lazima ikue aromatic. Lazima ikue na aroma, ikue na hiyo harufu. So when we define spices, this is how we define them. Write the definition. These are aromatic vegetable products. Now, as you can see, they are also coming from what? From plants. So they are aromatic vegetable products, or we can also write they are aromatic plant products. These are aromatic vegetable products obtained from the roots, obtained from the roots, former flowers, fruits. Roots or seeds of plants. They are aromatic vegetable products obtained from the roots, stem, flowers, fruits, or seeds of plants. So the major difference between the spice and the herb is that the spices are aromatic, zikona hiyo characteristic aroma. They are highly scented. Another statement down there. Spices are classified into three. Spices are classified into three. Namely, we have a hot spices. Hot spices. Now, hot spices are the ones that you find. They are spices. They are very aromatic, but zikona kaukali kama ile ya pilipili. So, hot spices, e.g., ginger. Ginger is a spice. So, e.g., ginger. Also, garlic. Garlic inakuaga both. Garlic is a herb, and garlic is also a spice. But now, we are going to use the hot spice. The example of a hot spice ni ginger. Ginger ni kali kama pilipili. But then it is also very aromatic, kuna harufu kubwa, harufu nyingi. So hot spices. B, mild spices. Mild spices. So something is mild, it's average, not too hot, not too cool. So mild spices, e.g. cumin. Cumin is a very good example of a mild spice. Kali sana na. So cumin. Then C. Aromatic. See? Aromatic spices. Hizi ni zile zenye ziko na a lot of aroma. Aromatic spices. E.g. cinnamon. If you know cinnamon, you know how aromatic it is. So now vitu kama cinnamon, cardamom, ziko hapo. Pia nutmeg, cassia bark, all those. They are very aromatic spices. So we classify them into three. We have hot, mild, and aromatic. Now, below there to andike some examples. Commonly used spices. Examples of commonly used spices. Examples of commonly used spices. Examples of commonly used spices. We have turmeric. Turmeric. We have ginger. We have curry powder. Curry powder. Curry powder is also a hot spice. Kuna harufu na kuna kaukali. Then we have mixed spices. Mixed spices. Mixed spices. Then we also have nutmeg. We have nutmeg. We have cloves. Cloves. So those are examples. I've said cinnamon, turmeric, curry powder, ginger, mixed spices, nutmeg, cloves. All those are examples of commonly used spices. Now, next is storage of spices. Storage of spices. Tabitha, do you have a question? Tabitha, question? Okay, sawa. Okay, storage of spices. Now, the storage of spices is like similar to the one of herbs. So write number one, store in tight-fitting containers. Store in tight-fitting containers. That is our point number one. And I've already said that the reason why we store in tight-fitting containers is to simply make sure that it does not absorb any moisture. Then point number two. Point number two on storage. Purchase on a regular basis. Purchase, kununua. Purchase on a regular basis. Purchase on a regular basis. Because once they have been ground, because once they have been ground, ku ground ni kama kumil, kuisiaga, when they become powdery. So once they have been ground, they lose their strength. They lose their strength, flavor, and color when stored for long. They should be purchased on a regular basis, because once they have been ground, they lose their strength, aroma, flavor, and color when stored for long. They should be purchased on, yes, I am repeating that. They should be purchased on a regular basis. They should be purchased on a regular basis because once they have been ground, they lose their strength, comma, flavor, and color. They lose their strength, flavor, and color once they have been ground. Unasema ground, ku grind. Unasema once they have been ground. They lose their strength, comma, flavor, and color when stored for long. Okay, you can now confirm whether you've gotten the entire point or you still need me to repeat it. Have you gotten the point, Abdullahi? Or you still need me to repeat it? Confirm. Whether I should still repeat the point. Okay, another person who is not getting me. Godfrey, are you getting me? Lorato, are you getting me? Tabitha? How is it on your side? Okay. Okay, so then Abdullahi, I think the connection problem maybe is on your side. Yeah, okay, so. So now that is about the storage of spices. So the last point we have said that you don't purchase them in bulk. You purchase on regular basis, manageable amounts and quantities, so that you do not end up storing them for long. Why? Because we are saying if we store them for long, then they lose that strength, they lose that flavor and aroma. You find that they are not as aromatic as they are when they are a bit new. So you avoid storing them for long so that you can get the benefit of getting the strength, the flavor, and the color of spices. Okay.